Harmony surfing at its best with the Glams on GMD.
Get away with that. The cops were doing their job. We would not need the Subway pancakes, and we would not be having this.
Captain Bob, nobody needs you. They all hate you. What do you say to that?
We don't like violence.
All I have to say is, if you're down in the subway and you see something big dressed in pink, watch out. Bob!
Look, I might not be a bloody duke, but I'll tell you one thing.
People like you really get up my bloody nose. The little bastard.
You had to get involved!
Soon to be encased in a can that you can open with a key, these creatures enjoy their last moments.
Come non capisci, ma come non capisci? Tu mi devi ascoltare!
Nel da pisto!
We are all going to die!
Coming next, the Glam Metal Detectors. Also tonight, Benny's Mad Dash, The Big Me, Bloodsports, and Colin Corleone.
Detectives, your mission is to save this planet's ecology with your top hit records. That's all for now.
Yes, Mr. President. The kids are on what? Why, that's terrible. Well, the Glams are on stage right now, and then they're off to a big Hollywood party. But as it's that important, of course, I'll tell them at once.
Come here. You know what to do.
You all.
Just do it, do it, do it!
Justice! Fucking justice for all!
Great gig, guys. I think they want a fifth encore.
I don't see why, Mark. They weren't even looking at us.
Listen, they're still shouting for more.
They're shouting for more throughout the whole show. Hmm.
Look, Jack Nicholson.
Dad!
Hi, hey. Jack!
Hey, it's my lucky day, huh? Yeah. How you doing, guys?
Right.
That was a hell of a gig, huh?
Thanks,
you goddamn cracker asses. Listen, do you want to come down to Ralph Reader's goddamn gang show?
Yeah, sounds great.
We're going to have one hell of a time, you know what I mean?
Right.
All right, guys, party's off. Something's come up. I need everyone back on the bus.
Oh, no. Okay. Great.
Oh, Gary, I almost forgot. There's a young girl from Guitar Hero Monthly. She says she wants to do an interview with you.
Guitar Hero Monthly? Interview? With me?
Yeah, she says she'd like to talk to you about your fingering. Just give her a couple of quotes, and I'll see you back on the bus.
Oh, hello.
I'm Gary. You must be the girl from the magazine that wants to talk to me about my guitar playing, yeah?
So.
All right.
You play, guitar.
Yeah.
Just take that down.
Right, okay. Next question?
I thank you. Drink?
Oh, what kind of drink?
It's just a little pick-me-up. It'll make you feel really, really,
really. Really,
really?
All right, yeah, I'm game.
Try.
Yeah. All right,
Oh, it's good, huh?
What is it? Splat.
Splat? What's that?
It's a brown drink with bubbles. It looks and tastes very much like another brown drink with bubbles, only this bubbly brown drink is different. Last week, here in Hollywood, we had reports of kids becoming boss-eyed.
Oh, no.
One of the major Splat side effects.
So what you're saying is one swig of Splat and you're...
Exactly. The president is very concerned and has requested our help.
Not you, darn kid!
after becoming boss-eyed, the typical splat victim becomes loud, selfish, arrogant and bossy with delusions of grandeur. It also says here that he or she thinks they're extremely sexy and everything they say is profound, when in fact it's utter hogswash.
Oh, Gary, let me just brief you on what's been going on here.
Shut up! Listen, I'm talking. From now on, it's Gary. Gary the movie. Me or me or me or me. Gary Box. Gary Burgers. Here's Gary. Gary. Gary and the Glams, Mark.
Sorry you feel that way, Gary. I've always tried to run it down.
And I want my own bed. Oh, yes. Leave it!
What's with Gary? You don't think that...
Hey, get some splat here!
Yeah, get it while you
Because splat makes you feel really, really, really good! Soon, the whole world's gonna be on splat!
Do you have trouble keeping that bath water in? Now you can keep your bath full of water with Bath Plugs from J&M Bath Plugs, City Road, York.
Come to Nobby's Nosher. Just off the A4 by Black Hill Quarry. You won't get a better fully fried nosher. And if you ain't hungry, just come in for a jet. Nobby's Nosher.
Why don't you try this herbal drink, Gary?
Emperor Gary! Ah!
There's very little data on splat, Mark.
All right, keep exploring all possibilities,
Phil. I think I've got something, Mark.
Right,
what have you got, Doon?
The Mona Lisa.
Look at her eyes, George.
The Mona Lisa, a splat addict.
Right, get everything you can about Leonardo da Vinci, Doon.
Hey, why don't you run it through the Earth History System, Mark? Then we can talk to him direct.
This is an emergency, Mark.
Yeah, right.
All right. Just this once. Be careful in there.
Right, Dimitri, Leonardo.
Permission to go into the Earth History System.
April 1452, Angelo da Vinci, Florence.
Mona Lisa, I'm a painter. You sound like a lady with a lovely smile.
Hello, Mr. Da Vinci.
Hello, boys.
We're from 500 years in the future.
Oh, nice. Anyone bought all my paintings yet?
Oh, yes. They're worth millions.
Oh, well, I've got a lot over here. How about this one? Or this one? Look, it's a nice elephant.
Well, they're very nice, Mr. Da Vinci, but what could you tell us about splat?
Oh, yes, splat song. Yeah, it's a nice, but it makes you feel like this all the time.
We also have a splat problem when we are, Mr. Da Vinci.
The whole of Rome wants my antidote for splat song. Hey, you seen this? I call it the helicoptera. I'm telling you what. You tell me how this thing flies, and I'll give you the antidote.
What are we going to do, Mark?
Okay, let's do it. Let's do it quick. We've got to be on stage in 5 minutes.
Fucking justice for all. Everybody
up. Whoa.
How are you feeling, Gary?
Oh, much better, thanks, Mark.
Maybe you better have another swig of that antidote in case the first one didn't work. Right, let's get that strange girl off splat and find out who's really, really behind all this. It's up to you, Gary.
Right.
Really?
Drink? Huh?
Oh.
How you feeling, strange girl?
Oh, really, Billy. Oh, awful. And here's my story. I was going to be a Hollywood movie star, acting and everything. And then last Thursday, I met Ralston, and I can't remember anything since.
Ralston?
Yeah, Ralston.
Ralston Brocade, international villain and overweight ex-media tycoon, hell-bent on world power.
Well, we got a little surprise for that Ralston Brocade, right?
Let's do it.
Splodge?
Splosh.
What's that?
It's an antidote that makes you never want to take Splat ever again.
You're never going to get those kids off Splat.
That's where you're wrong.
We've substituted all the Splat cans with Splosh.
What? Oh, no!
Oh, yes. The game's over, Ralston. The kids are off Splat and you're off to jail.
Why, you darn kids!
What's that, Commander? We're number one in Tibet. Well, that's good, because we're playing there next week.
It's hard to imagine, isn't it, that the world's most popular sport is punching syrup.
So for $10,000, you are going to put your relationship on the line.
Yes, we are.
So, Ted, you love Gina?
I do.
And you love Ted?
Oh, I sure do.
We're going to break this marriage up right after this.
Are you a smoker? Are you tired of people saying you can't smoke here, you can't smoke there, you can't smoke anywhere? Well, come to Smacky's Smoke Palace.
No smoking here. It's yes smoking at Smacky's Smoke Palace. Cigars and pipes welcome too.
So, Ted, you thought your marriage was safe, but you forgot your special friend, Julian, all the way from San Francisco. Price of love.
Price of love, indeed.
Listen up, Bedford. I'm the Queen of England round here, and I will have you both hung, drawn, and quartered faster than a possum licks grease.
Yeah, mate, one bloody move and this pipe goes right through you.
I love to swim!
Still to come, Betty's Mad Dash, the Big Me, and Colin Corleone.
Hello and welcome back to Ram Raiding. Tonight we're coming to you live from the Jubilee Shopping Centre in Leicester.
Well, we just had confirmation on a great result. Young Mickey Campbell, who done matters in 3.5 minutes, has come away with 7.5 grand. The winner now is the current national champion, Billy the Magpie Baxter, one of Britain's best loved Ram Raiders. A great result for young Mickey Campbell, don't you think?
Well, he's a strong driver, he's quick in the shot, but I don't see it as a threat.
So what will you be going for tonight then, Billy?
Right, I'm looking at Dixon's in under 5 minutes.
That's good, but any predictions on the whole, Billy?
Well, it's a solid car with a large boot. I reckon 10 grand worth of electrical goods.
Thank you, Bob. Just time to give you a quick result. We've got a shock result coming in from Bristol. Lonnie Klepto Davison, favourite to win tonight, has missed Samuel's Jewelers after a brake failure, and he's ended up in the pick and mix section at Woolworths. Bad result there, Ted. Woolworths pick and mix?
Well, I mean, you know, what can I say? I mean, Lenny Klepto Davison, he is a fine smash and grab artist. I mean, he's at the top of his game, really. And you know, when they talk about smash and grab, you always talk about Lenny Klepto. But what's gone wrong there? I really can't explain it. It's obviously a rush of blood to the head, and the young fella's obviously gone into the Woolworths there when he should be in the Jewellers, reaping the rich harvest that he would have reaped had he got in there.
Would you stick your neck out and write him off?
Well, I won't stick my neck out that far and go forward and say that I would write him off, but I will just come back a little bit and say, yes, I think so. But, I mean, who am I? Who am I?
Tomorrow night, a tale of heartache and torment and a search for identity.
The waves will continue to pound and pound, and our wretched torment will begin again.
The hollyhocks have seen it on the dark wall, and Annabella is calling to us.
Utterly, Lytton, the seagulls have nested in the lighthouse. Don't you see, Lytton? I am the sea. The sea is me.
Arseholes of the Sea. Part of our naked season, here on Channel 4.
We love it! We love the swim!
Here's the bodies, sir.
Gee, are these guys all sleeping?
No, they're dead, sir.
Oh, death. Oh, what a blow. It comes to us all, eh?
Right away, sir.
Seven deadly veils.
Oh, Zeus, hear your slave. Why must such a new...
Hello. What do you do? Come on, Maisie, we're on.
Oh, no! But thou shalt be mine for all eternity. God, Helen of Troy! Stay upstage of me. The face that launched 1,000 ships at 3C4. But a day, and thou shalt be mine for all eternity! These are the riches!
All of you, throw your jewelry onto the stage at once, or I'll shoot!
You, yes, you on the third row. Sling that gold watch up here, or you'll be sorry.
And the pearls, madam. If you'd be so kind, fork them over at once.
Maisie, behind you!
For Betty and Maisie. Don't miss next week's enthralling episode of Betty's Mad Dash.
Tomorrow night, part 4 of the award-winning Scandal in a Diving Bell.
Surprise!
Happy birthday to you.
Scandal in a Diving Bell. Tomorrow night.
I wonder what was going on.
Happy birthday! A mo, a mass, a mass.
Stuck in a girl's school. Want to learn more than Latin? Well, call Mickey on 0898-696969. Here's one class you won't skip.
too.
Everyone's teacher's pet with Mickey.
Oi, where's the bloody queen? I'm going out.
5, 4, 3, 2...
Ladies and gentlemen,
welcome to the big...
Hey! You look great, Mariah.
Thanks. What little morsels have you got for us, then?
Well, it's a bit of a surprise.
Oh, good, I love surprises.
Well, I know you're going to fall for this one.
Well, talking of falling, my next guest, when he was only 2 years old, fell 3,000 feet out of an aeroplane into a snowdrift.
Wow, a snowdrift. How did he survive?
Well, you're not going to believe this. He was raised by a pack of wolves, and until last week had never seen another human being. Ladies and gentlemen, a huge round of applause for Wolf Boy Jack! So, Wolf Boy Jack, thanks for joining us. Now tell me, what a story. There you are, up in the mountains, miles away from civilization. I mean, probably existing on a diet of raw meat, I don't know what. What is it like being covered in fur? Because I remember the time I went to a fancy dress party dressed as a cat.
It was a puma, wasn't it?
Oh, that's right, it was a puma. And I had this terrible rash under my arms. It was awful. That was the time I was with my first boyfriend.
Was that the waiter or the traffic cop?
Traffic cop. Anyway, Wolf Boy, I mean, so you do not get awfully itchy hands with all that stuff? Because I remember the time I had to wear these rubber gloves for a show. And I got this terrible rash underneath the gloves. And I had to keep taking them off. They were so furious with me.
You've always been a natural for
the camera. Oh, I've always felt.
Except that time on Blankety Blank.
Uh-huh. Oh no, Blankety Blank, I'm absolutely blank. I just couldn't do anything.
Drive fast, get cash. Drive fast, girls must have, cars must have. Success. Are you getting it?
Welcome back to the Big Me, and this is what really happened. Here you have your snow scene, you've got your pack of wolves here, and here is your 747.
Ladies and gentlemen, we choose to get an altitude of 3,000 feet. Just go to the toilet. Oh, what's that button? Ah, I've dropped my baby! Ah!
Oh no, I'm lost. Oh. What's that? Have you got any chum?
No,
I'm just a wee salad and I'm lost.
And now the life and times of Colin Corleone.
I know you have urgent family business to see to, but today is a very big day for all of us, especially your sister. Getting married is a big day for anyone. I don't ask much of you, Colin, but I'm asking you just this once. If we could please have the use of your bedroom. Please. Godfather?
How long have you known me?
Since you was born. I'm your mother.
Yeah, she's his mama.
Yeah, she's his mother.
That's what I said.
Yeah, she's his mama.
Hey, what's the matter with you?
What's the matter with you?
I said she's his mama.
That's what I'm saying. She's his mama.
And all this time, never once did you call me godfather.
I just did.
Never once until this day, knowing that I cannot refuse any request made of me on this day, the day of my sister's wedding.
Mum, just tell the little twat to get out of the room. He can't breathe out here.
Wait a blip, Mary. Thank you, Colin. I do appreciate it.
Leave me now, and in time I will grant you this request.
Thank you.
Would you boys like a beer?
Oh, yes, please, Mrs. Potter.
Fredo, hug my mama.
Eh? What?
Hug his mama.
Yeah, okay, I'm gonna hug the mother.
Hug the mama now!
Alright, I'm
hug
gonna...
Hug her!
Okay, I'm hugging the mother!
He's the little git going to give us a room or what? It's like bloody hell!
Come on, Colin, sort it out!
Okay,
just
calm
down,
come on,
let's
get out of here.
He's thinking about it. Just give him a minute.
Yeah, just, okay, that's it, okay.
What's going on here? Are we losing control?
Excuse me, boys. The toilet?
Hey, you, Padre, take a walk. Yeah, you!
Take a walk, take a walk.
Everything's okay, boss.
Ain't that the truth, huh?
Today's my sister's wedding. The happiest day of her life. A happy day in all our lives. We're Italians.
Why can't we come in here?
Yes, Mama. Why can't we come in here?
Yeah, okay, kids. Here. Let's take a walk. Come on.
We can.
My father's going to butter you.
Yes, sure, yeah, sure. Come on, let's get out of here.
Stranger.
Take a hike.
Colin! Colin, I want this room now! And no messing around. It is too crowded out there. You're being unreasonable and totally selfish, Colin.
Look at all grown up and dressed and wearing.
Knock it off, Colin! Knock off all this godfather stuff! It's your sister's wedding, you selfish little git! Knock it off, Colin! Just go operate! You are wrecking my wedding!
Calm down, Alan. You're going to burst a blood vessel or something in there.
It's great for you to have the room, sir. You're in the room, haven't you, Colin?
It's too late! He's wrecking my wedding! And he's wrecking my life!
Oh! You see what you've done, you little prick?
Oh, baby, come back, come on!
Take this woman out of here, she's getting hysterical.
Nice one, Colin.
Nice one, Marlon.
I wasn't wrong, was I, Colin? You did say we could have the use of your room.
Didn't I tell you never to ask me about family business?
Did you?
Yes.
I knew it.
Now, if you don't mind, I would like to go to my sister's wedding.
Now, at the time coming up to 17 minutes past 2, for all you night owls, it's time to go over for another half hour of stand-up comedy with this week's guest star, Willie Witless.
Are you well? Are you well? Yes!
Anyway!
Where'd you get your suit?
Lincoln.
Come on, Willie, your taxi's arrived. Get off.
And, two astronauts on the moon, and one says to the other, it's good here, isn't it? And the other one says, yeah, have you got any crisps on it?
Get off,
man. Anyway.
Bill. It appears he's been kidnapped by some furry thing that's demanding drum lessons.
He does a great Tommy Cooper, listen.
I suggest we play along with his game and pray this thing's got rhythm.